Hello everyone, so in this video I will explain how we can install the latest Java version using Homebrew. So let's first check what is the latest version currently. So I'll go to the Oracle's official website. Here you can see there are two versions listed here, 21 and 17. So 17 is the LTS version, which is why it is listed here, and the 21, which is just recently got released in the September month. So that's why it is available to install. So one way is to download the DMG file or the binary file here and install it directly. I would create another video for that. For now, let's focus to install Java through Homebrew. Since 21 is the latest version, so we will install the 21 version through Homebrew. So let's go to the terminal now. For this, obviously the Homebrew should be installed on your system. Then let's search for the Java using the brew search command. So if you have followed my Homebrew course, then you would know what is the brew search command. So it searches any package which matches the name whatever we mentioned in the command. So let's search for Java. So it will list down all the formula and cask type of application. So here we are interested in Java only. Let's see the information about this Java package. So let's run the command brew info and Java. Here comes the information about this Java package. So we have already discussed about this bottle, what is this, in the Homebrew course. So if you want to know in detail about these terms, you can follow the Homebrew course. For now, I'll briefly explain. So bottled is denoting the binary files. So it means it is already compiled and will get only the binary files. The keg only means after the installation of Java, the binary files will not be symlinked automatically. If we want, we will have to do that manually. So here also it is written, this is the command to symlink the openjdk.jdk file. And here also it is saying that openjdk is keg only, which means it will not be symlinked into opt/homebrew, because there can be another versions of Java which will conflict then and it can create issues. So it will not symlink by default. Then other things, these are the libraries which are required for Java to run properly, and this green tick means they are already installed in my system. Then the macOS should be 10.15, which is Catalina. So I am using Ventura, so it will work fine for me. So please check for your system as well. And this is the Ruby files location where this formula is hosted. So let's go to this particular location once to see what is there in this file. So I'll go to the browser and so here you can see the entire Ruby file is there. As you see here, this is JDK21U. So it means the JDK21 will be installed when we install the Java, which we had searched on the terminal. So here we searched the Java. So if we install this Java package, so the 21 version will be installed. Okay, great. One more thing, if you notice here that it is pointing the file name is openjdk.rb. So what is the difference between Java and OpenJDK? So let's search for this OpenJDK once to understand this. So if I search the OpenJDK, so there is one search result comes, which is openjdk.rb, on which we are already present. The another one is openjdk@21. Let's go to that. So here you can see this is alias. This is not the actual file, and also it is pointing to the same file. So if we install openjdk@21 in the command line using brew install openjdk@21, then also it will install the same thing, because this is also referring to the same file. Then let's search for Java also. So if I go to this particular file, so as you can see, this is also alias. And wow, this is also pointing to the same file, openjdk.rb, which is a Ruby file. So it means if I install using this package or this Java or the OpenJDK or the openjdk@21, all three things will install the JDK21, so we can use any one of them. So let's install now. So view, install, then Java. Let's pick any of them. You can use OpenJDK or OpenJDK@21 also. So it might take a couple of minutes for you, because for me, some packages were already installed in my system. So it might take some more time for you to install these packages first, then it will install the OpenJDK. So it is installed now. Then it is saying either we should symlink this using this command, or we can run this command to modify our path so that the Java or Java C, those binaries will be found easily. So let's symlink this. You can choose any of the way, both ways are fine. So I am going ahead with this. So okay, before that, let's see whether it is working or not currently. So if I remove this, then if I do Java version, then you can see even though OpenJDK is installed, but it is not able to find any Java runtime. So we will have to run either of the command. So let's run this. So it will ask the MAC password here. Okay, so it is symlinked now. Let me clear the screen once so that it is visible properly. Now if I do again Java version, great. So now we can see the OpenJDK 21 is installed in my system. Okay, so I have created one file also, one Java program. So let me show you that Java program as well. So this is a simple hello world program. Let's try to run this. First I will compile this, then let's run this. Great, so it is working fine. So it means the Java is installed, and since 21 is the latest version, it has installed the 21 for me. Following these steps, you would have also installed successfully. If you face any issue, please let me know in comment section, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.